मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? सो लेट्स बिगिन आर डे फॉर कंप्यूटर्स. ओके, सो हियर इज आई एम विथ योर फर्स्ट चैप्टर, दैट इज कंप्यूटर स्टोरी. एज मे यू रिमेंबर दैट इन लास्ट ईयर यू हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द हिस्ट्री ऑफ कंप्यूटर, where you have seen how the computers has been developed, right? Means you have seen from abacus to the mechanical machine or analytical machine of Charles Babbage. So you have seen that complete circle of the development of computer in last year. Then we have seen the generation of computer. So to elaborate the topic means the development of computer device, we are going to study about how these computer can be classified in generations. Like, as we know, like people, those are living around us, having their grandparents, parents, and then children. So that are the generation of human being, right? Like earlier, before you, there were your grandfather. That time, for the entertainment, what they were having? They were having the stage shows or puppet shows. Then, after great-grandfather, grandfathers came. In grandfather's time, the movies and cinema was there, but it was black and white, right? Then, in the next generation, when your father, your parents came, then at the time of your parents, what came? That was colored televisions and old computers. But nowadays, when you are studying, now you are having smart computers, right? And lots of games, even the virtual games as well, right? So this we can divide our generation along with the devices. So here we are going to see the development of computer, means the generation of computer, means as we have seen our generation, now we can see the generation of computer. So in that, let's discuss the generation of computer. Okay, so let's go ahead. Generation of computers, right? So when we are talking about computer, the different computers means after the computer that was designed by Charles Babbage, then the other machines came. We can divide those computer in five generations. In that series, the first generation comes, and that first generation computers were from 1940 to 1956. Okay, 1940 to 1950. Six, and in that computers, the main parts for the processing that was used was vacuum tubes. Means like nowadays, you know that microprocessors are using. We are using microprocessors, right? So in that time of computer, when the first generation computer was in use, so that time for processing, vacuum tubes were used. These vacuum tubes were large in size, and as because they were built of fiberglass, right? So they got heated very early, and as they got heated, they could burst out. So that was very difficult to find out while the processing is going on which tube has been burst out, then replace that tube, and then again moving ahead the calculation and the processing was a tedious and a difficult job. And that's why the computer were very bulky in size, and they were very difficult to port from one place to another. Even they were not portable. So those computers were very bulky in size, used vacuum tubes, and a large expense was there to maintain. And the example of those computers are UNIVAC, ENIAC, and IBM 701. These are some example of first generation computer. Then, when, because as you know, the invention is the mother of necessity is the mother of invention, right? So, because these vacuum tubes were creating problems, as for the processing they were bursting out, so the solution was shorting out by the scientists. So then they developed another thing, that was transistors. So in second generation computer, means from 1956 to 1963, for the processing the vacuum tubes were replaced by transistors. Okay, तो अब वैक्यूम ट्यूब के प्लेस पर क्या आ गए, ट्रांजिस्टर्स. नाउ ट्रांजिस्टर्स वेयर लाइट इन साइज, देन स्मॉलर इन साइज, एंड देवर कंपेरेटिवली देवर गेट हीटेड लिटिल लेट. सो बिकॉज ऑफ दैट दीज ट्रांजिस्टर्स वेयर ईजियर टू रिप्लेस्ड. वन मोर थिंग इन दैट सेकेंड जनरेशन कंप्यूटर, दैट अलॉन्ग विद द ट्रांजिस्टर्स द मैग्नेटिक tape were used as a punch card to store data. Means in vacuum tubes or the first generation computer, the data storage was not available of that level. But when the second generation computer come and the transistors come, that time in that computers, magnetic tapes were started using to store the data. And they were using the punch card like of device to store the data in the form of punch card. So in second generation computer they were little bit faster than the first, then they were lighter in the size and they were smaller in the size. So all three things were improved. Then the example of their IBM 7090, IBM 7094 and Univac 110B. So these are the example of second generation computer. Then the next thing came, that was integrated circuits, means ICs. In third generation computer 1964 to 1971, transistors were replaced by ICs or integrated circuit. ये वो first computer थे जिनमें electronic circuit का use हुआ कैलकुलेशन के लिए. जब बूलियन ने अपनी बूलियन लॉजिक की थ्योरी प्रोवाइड की, तो उस बूलियन लॉजिक की थ्योरी को यूज़ करके ये इंटीग्रेटेड सर्किट या इलेक्ट्रॉनिक सर्किट डिज़ाइन किए गए. और उन डिज़ाइन इन सर्किट्स में सबसे बेटर बात ये थी कि ये जो सिलिकॉन चिप्स होती थी, ये जो इंटीग्रेटेड सर्किट थे, देवर डेवलप्ड ऑन सिलिकॉन चिप्स. और इनकी क्वालिटी बेटर सबसे ये है कि ये सब बहुत धीरे गर्म होते हैं, और अगर गर्म हो जाएं तो क्विकली ठंड कूल डाउन हो जाते हैं. तो जो हीट वाली प्रॉब्लम थी और जो बर्स्ट आउट वाली प्रॉब्लम थी, वो थर्ड जनरेशन कंप्यूटर में लगभग सॉल्व हो गई. तो अब थर्ड जनरेशन कंप्यूटर में क्या हुआ, प्रोसेसिंग के लिए इंस्टेड ऑफ ट्रांजिस्टर ICs वेर यूज्ड. ICs वेर वेरी स्मॉलर इन साइज, वेरी फास्टर इन वर्क, एंड द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग, दे वेर वेरी स्लो टू गेट हीटेड and very earlier they could be cooled down. So that was the best thing about the third generation computer. And obviously the storage capacity were much better. And the best example of third generation computer is IBM 370. Okay, these IC chips later on were used in televisions also. Jo televisions hain unme bhi ICs ka use hone laga. Now the next is fourth generation computer. And in fourth generation computer the ICs were taken the place by microprocessor. These ICs were more later on enhanced and they have taken the form of microprocessor. And these microprocessors are still coming with upgradation. Every day a new microprocessor with new upgradation is available. So these fourth generation computers are the smarter and the current generation of computer from 1971 to till the time the fourth generation computer is in use. So fourth generation computer, their microprocessors were used and they were much lighter, much faster, and the most important thing, they are easily portable. They can easily port from one place to another. As you can see, you are handling your smartphone, that is also a kind of computer, and everywhere you can keep it with you in your pockets. So that is the good thing about fourth generation computer. So the current generation that is going on is fourth generation computer, and nowadays we are having lots of example of these, like all the personal computers, laptops, tablets, they all are the present generation or fourth generation computers example. Now the fifth generation computer is in progress, means in present they are available, but later on also, present and beyond. And the good thing about, or the best thing about, is this, that they will have the artificial intelligence, means they will be able to understand the normal or a human language, and they will be able to learn by their experiences. They will be learn selfly. Like अभी आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस का बेस्ट एग्जाम्पल आप गूगल से ले सकते हो. गूगल में आप अपनी नॉर्मल और नेचुरल लैंग्वेज में टाइप करते हैं, बट इट इज़ एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड वॉट यू आर एग्जैक्टली ट्राइंग टू फाइंड आउट. इवन समटाइम यू कैन स्पीक इन हिंदी और इन अदर लैंग्वेज बाई यूजिंग द ऑडियो और द वॉइस रिकग्निशन सिस्टम, एंड देन दे आर एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड योर सर्च. So that is the example of artificial intelligence. As you type one or two letter, it gives you the suggestions, the related words spelling. So that is also the example of artificial intelligence. Your virtual games are also the kind of that. So these are the quality of artificial intelligence. So these are still in the development stage. Abhi bhi ho rahe hain, like you have seen the example of many devices are coming that are using voice recognition system, like Alexa. You can call, you can give your data by voice, and then they will reprocess and retrieve the output with a single device. So these kind of development is going on, and very soon they will be in use. So these are the generations of computers. So what you have seen, have a quick recapitulation. Like first generation computer, vacuum tubes were used, problematic as they were get heated and burst out. Then they were bulky in size and difficult to port. Then second generation, vacuum tubes replaced by transistor, smaller in size, faster than the first generation computer, and use magnetic tape and punch card to store data. Then in third generation computer, integrated circuit, means ICs came. They were very smaller in size, less problematic to get heated, and very fast and small. Then the fourth generation computer came, means the present generation, where now the microprocessors are being used. They are very easy to port from one place to another, very fast and very light in weight. And the fifth generation computer will have artificial intelligence, which is continuously in the process of development. Okay, so these all are our generations of computer, five generation computer. Okay, now we will see the classification of computer. So when we talk about classification of computer, as we have divided our computer in generations, right, from first to fifth. Now in present generation computer also can be divided into different types. Like these computer can be divided in four main type on the basis of their size and speed. So we can divide these computers in four types. And they are like microcomputer, the smallest one, then the mini computer, the bigger one, then one more is there, that is mainframe computer, and the fourth one is supercomputer. So you can divide computers in four kinds on the basis of their size and speed. Microcomputer means our personal computers, then the mini computers, those are using in organizations. Then the mainframe computer, which are used in the multinational companies or the bigger organizations like railways, airways kind of organizations. And then the supercomputer, those are used for space research centers, weather forecasting and etc. So those are the supercomputers. So these are the four main types of computer that we can divide in the basis of size and speed. So these all types of computer we will discuss in our next class, where we will discuss microcomputer, mini computer, mainframe computer and the supercomputer. So that's all for the day. So you read the generations of computer, try to learn the technologies are used in that and their examples. So that's all for from my side for the day. Have a nice day. Stay happy, stay healthy. Bye bye.